Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing this look for you guys. I am going to be using the Alamar Cosmetics Reina del Caribe Volume 1 eyeshadow palette. I received this eyeshadow palette in my June BoxyCharm and I just had to do a look with it like right away. So this is the look that I created. It is very vibrant, very just kind of like tropical and just so beautiful. This video is going to be a little bit different than most of my videos just because this is going to just be a eye makeup tutorial where I just focus on the eyes and the rest of the face I pretty much skip through. Everything I use will be in the description box just in case there's something that you see on me that you like. Everything will be listed down below, but since those products are pretty much ones I use in almost every single one of my videos, I didn't really have anything new to try, so I just figured I'd just show you the eyes because that's what we're here for. It's kind of like a review slash demo on this palette. So yeah, if you'd like to see how I got this look, then just go ahead and keep on watching. So I'm going to be starting off by priming my eyes. I'm using my Essence I Love Stage eyeshadow base. And the first shade I'm going to be dipping into is the shade Coco Taxi. And as you guys can see, as I'm pressing my brush into the palette, there really isn't any kick up. So I'm going to be taking my Morphe M505 and I'm going to be working this shade into the crease. I started off by applying kind of like a light layer of the shade. I wasn't sure how like intense it was going to be. So I did decide to dip into the shade again. And as you guys can see, it doesn't really have any kick up. I always go ahead and dust off my brush before applying it onto the eye just because I don't want to get a lot of fallout, but as you can see with the second application, it is getting a little bit deeper and I feel like it's a really nice transition shade. And now I'm going to be going in with the shade Tropico. And as you guys can see, it is very pigmented. And I did go ahead and tap off my brush before applying it onto my eye. And I am going to be using a Morphe M330, which is a lot more of like a tapered blending brush. And I'm going to be applying the shade Tropico into my crease, but I am going to be applying it slightly under the shade Coco Taxi. And I'm really going to be working with this shade. They're super easy to apply and blend out. They honestly blend themselves. I really am impressed with this formula. And once I got it to kind of like the deepness that I wanted and made sure to really blend it out, I'm going to be going back in with the shade Coco Taxi just to make sure that we don't lose that shade with all the blending that we did. And now I'm going to be going in with my Rimmel Match Perfect Concealer, and I'm pretty much just going to be carving out the lid. I do this in a ton of my videos, and I really like the way it makes my shadow look. I pretty much just kind of make my lid look bigger and really shape it by applying the concealer a little bit higher into the crease. And I am going to be applying this concealer kind of like halfway onto the lid and leaving the outer corner blank. And then I'm just going to be taking my Morphe M505 and kind of blending out the harsh lines from the concealer. And now for the lid shade, I'm going to be taking the shade El Malecón, which is such a beautiful shimmer. It's like a green with kind of like flecks of gold, I want to say. Like, it's a very different shade, and I'm going to be taking it with a brush. I'm using a flat shader brush from the brand Bodyography, and as you can see, the palette didn't like cause any kick up, and it is super intense with like first application. As you guys can see, I'm like so amazed by this shadow, and I didn't want to like edit through this part at all, so you guys can really see like my initial thoughts and like really see how this shadow performs. Like, I didn't have to wet it, my brush isn't wet, it's honestly that good. Like, it's one of the best shimmers I've ever used. It applied so easily, and it wasn't like that crumbly formula. It didn't mess up the pan, and it also didn't like look weird on my eye. Like, I'm obsessed with this shade. It looks and applies so beautifully. And once I'm done applying the lid shade, I will go in with a clean blending brush and just blend out the crease. And now I'm going to be using the shade Celia, and I'm going to be applying that to kind of like the mid portion slash outer portion of the eye. It's such a beautiful green. I feel like if I would have wet it, it would have been more of like that true green that you see in the palette. But I do feel like it did blend really well with the El Malecón shade. It wasn't too intense. I didn't want it to be like too green either. So I actually really liked how it applied, and it picked up well on a brush and applied beautifully. It's a very creamy formula. I'm very excited to see what else Alamar Cosmetics comes out with, because these shimmers are amazing. And now I'm going to be taking the shade Cafecito, and I'm going to be using a Real Techniques brush. This is a base shadow brush. It's pretty much just kind of like a small tapered fluffy brush, and I'm going to be focusing this shade on the outer portion of the eye. I don't want to go too far in with this shade because I did apply the shimmer and I want that to be like the star of the look. So I'm going to be working very slowly with this shade because I don't want it to get too dark. So I'm going to be blending that on the outer portion of the eye, and once I get it to like the desired darkness, I am going to be going in with a clean fluffy brush to really make sure to blend it out and make sure it doesn't look too dark or muddy. These shadows have a way of blending so easily, but since I didn't want it to be too intense, I was working very slowly with this shadow and having like a lot of patience with it, so the look wouldn't turn too dark. And honestly, this step you can skip it because I do apply liner, and I kind of went in thick with my liner so you don't even see like the deepness in the outer portion of the eye. And off camera, I went ahead and applied liner. I used my Tarte Sex Kitten liner. And now with a Morphe B37, I'm going to be going in with the shade Coco Taxi. I already went ahead and applied my foundation, concealer, powders. So I'm going to be applying that from outer corner to inner corner of the eye and really making sure to smoke it out. I love this tiny little brush because I feel like it does a great job of applying the product and blending it out so easily without it like hurting my under eye. And now I'm going to be taking the shade Tropico with the same brush. I'm applying it from the outer portion to inner portion of the eye. I'm really making sure to take my time with this shade because I don't want it to be too intense and like too orangey down on the lower lash line. So I am going to be taking a clean brush and making sure to blend it out. And now I'm picking up the shade Coco Taxi with this Luxe 221T brush. It's a very tiny little brush and it's very precise. So I'm going to be applying that only on the outer corner of the eye, and then going back in with my Morphe B37 brush and blending it out, really making sure to focus that on the outer corner of the eye and not dragging it too far inward because I don't want this look to be too smoky. And now I'm taking the shade La Costa, and this is such a beautiful shade all over the lid, on the brow bone, inner corner. Like, this is my favorite shade in this palette. So I'm going to be using it to highlight my brow bone, and as you guys can see, it is very pigmented and just so pretty. Like, it's kind of has like a pinky goldish frost, or not even frost, like pigment. It is very intense and just so beautiful. So I'm also going to be using that shade to highlight the inner corners of my eyes as well, and it really does make a difference. It really makes the inner corners pop, and I love how it looked. And since the pan size is pretty big in this palette, I did decide to dip in my face brush and see how pretty this shadow would look as a highlight. And as you guys can see, it is really pretty and just intense. It isn't a chunky texture either. It's very like glowy and it looked like a highlight. I thought it looked beautiful on the skin as well. And off camera, I did apply these Ardell lashes. So this is the final look. I am so in love with how this look turned out. Literally the best $28 you will ever spend. I honestly, as you guys have been hearing me throughout this video, it's so pigmented, smooth, creamy, buttery. It's an amazing palette, and for $28 you get something so unique, so beautiful. I feel like you can just do so many different looks with this palette. Granted, it will be a bit warmer and a little bit bolder with the color choices that are in here, but I think it's amazing. It's something that isn't like every other palette that's on the market right now. Granted, don't get me wrong, I love my neutral shades. I love like a warm, just simple look, but this really gets you to step out of your comfort zone and it's beautiful. This look isn't like too crazy or too wild, but it is very like summery, kind of like tropical and just different. I normally don't do a green shadow every single day, but I made it work and well, not even made it work. Like, it looks beautiful. And honestly, with this pigmentation, I would rock a green eyeshadow look every single day if every single palette I had performed like this one. And I'm just so happy with it. I think it's so beautiful. I knew it was gonna be good, but it completely blew me away. Do I recommend it? 1000% yes. If you haven't gotten your hands on it, I would definitely go to the Alamar website and see if it's in stock, because with how amazing it is, I wouldn't be surprised if it's like already sold out, because this palette is so good. And I'm not even like trying to hype it up or make it sound like it's just amazing. No, like truly dip your brush in here and you shall see how amazing it is. So I will definitely be purchasing any other item or product that Alamar Cosmetics comes out with, whether that's another eyeshadow palette or a highlighter palette, whatever. I'm sold. Like, their formula is so good. Like, I don't think I've seen anything like it. Like, don't get me wrong, other brands have great quality shadows and they blend well and everything, but this palette, like, I didn't have to use my finger for the shadows, and that's not a big deal for me. Like, I'll use my fingers and everything, but for how much my brush picked up without me even having to try, I'm like, wow, I'm sold, I'm blown away. Like, this is truly, truly an awesome palette. If you guys have tried it out, definitely let me know down in the comments, like, what you think of it. Is it amazing? Do you love it? Do you hate it? I honestly can't see anyone hating it because it's truly that good. But let me know what you guys think about it if you have tried it. Definitely let me know if you guys would like to see me do another look with this palette. And thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!